Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters in Christ, wherever you are watching this evening, I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm privileged to bring you the message of hope this evening, and allow me to begin by saying thank you so much to our Venerable Archdeacon for giving me this opportunity, and I hope we are going to be blessed together. Allow me, we start with a word of prayer. Lord, our dear Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for being together with us. We thank you for the blessing of being healthy. We thank you for the care that you have taken for each and every one of us, O dear Lord. Even for the fact that we have come, Lord, we want to thank you and to bless your holy name, O dear Father. As I share your word this evening, O dear King of Glory, I believe it will bring hope and it will keep us going and going on, O dear Father. I call upon your Holy Spirit to come and manifest himself in our lives. For this I do pray, believe, and trust in Jesus' name. Amen. Once again, I greet you. Adam, I want to take this opportunity as we share the word of God, briefly from the word of Isaiah 43. This is a word that is very familiar to us, and mostly to those who like doing study and going through the word of God. In the book of Isaiah 43, today is where we are going to get our message, and my message and my theme today is about the theme in a hope in the midst. A hope in the midst, that is what we are going to look at the word today and see what God wanted to share with this great man called Jacob. And if you read just a few verses from the book of Isaiah 43, the Bible says that Jacob, the Lord created. Jacob, the Lord created you. Israel, he made you. And now, he says, do not be afraid. I saved you. I named you. You are mine. When you have trouble, I am with you. When you cross rivers, you will not be hurt. When you walk through fire, you will not be burnt. The flames will not hurt you. If we look at those few two verses, we see God talking to Jacob. And God was giving a hope to Jacob. And he was telling Jacob that when you go through the terrible and difficult and tough times that you are going through, I, the Lord, your God, who created you, and I know you by your name, you will not be swept away by the storms. You will not be burned by the flames of the fire. And that is what is happening to many of us Christians. If you look at the whole world today, the whole country in our Kenya, the global is full of storms, is full of fire, and we are like going through the fire. But the Bible is telling us, and this God was talking to Jacob, that when you go through this fire, when you pass through the rivers, you will not be burnt. I, the Lord your God, I will be with you. I will save you. I will rescue, because I know you by your name. So brothers and sisters, tonight I want to bring us a message of hope, reminding us and telling ourselves that even though we are going what we are going through, even though we may see like we have come to the end of our life, but God is telling us that I know you by your name. I will save you. I will rescue, because you are mine. We are God's people. We are the people that God have created. He created us with his own image, and therefore he is there to save us. He is there to rescue our lives. Yes, anything else may come to the end. We may lose our jobs. We may lose hope. We may look at our finances and we have come to the end of everything. But God is saying that I will save you, because I know you by your name. Brothers and sisters in your homes, I want to encourage someone. I want to tell someone, take hope. Look at God. Call upon God. Keep upon calling the name of God, because he's going to save you. And God is going to rescue our lives, because he's a God of love. God who created us with our own image. And therefore, as even we go through this pandemic, I know it's just a matter of time. I know it's just a matter of time that God is going to save us. God is going to rescue his people, because he knows us by our own name. Let us not lose hope. Let us keep on putting our focus, looking upon the mountain. And that is what David was saying in the book of Psalms, that when I look upon the mountain, where do my help come from? My help comes from the Lord. And that is what I want to tell ourselves tonight, that our help comes from the Lord. It is only by calling upon the name of God. It is only by putting our hope and our faith upon Him, because He is saying that I know you by your names. I will save you. We will not die. We are not going to get finished. He is there to save our life. He is there to study together with us. He is there to fight the battle for us, because we belong to Him. So brothers and sisters, do not lose hope. There is a promise in the midst of this journey that God is going to save us, that God is going to walk this journey with us, and He's going to save our lives. So be encouraged. Take heart. Look upon the Lord. Look up to the mountain. Call upon the God, as David could do. He could call upon God. He could cry to God. And God was saving even the children of Israel, because they trusted in God. So even to tonight, to us, I want to encourage ourselves to keep on looking upon Him and calling upon His name, because He is saying that I, the Lord, I created you, Jacob, and I know you by your name. You are mine. You are my people. You will not perish in this journey. I will save you. I will fight the battle for you. I will protect you. And the hand of the Lord is upon our life. He is going to save us, because we are His people. So let us keep on looking upon Him, looking upon the mountain, looking upon the Lord, watching and waiting upon the Lord, because everything else may come to the end. We may get tired of this journey. We may look and see like we have taken so much in this pandemic, but God is saying that I'm going to save you, and I know you by your name. So brothers and sisters, tonight, let us keep on looking upon to the Lord, and that is the only way God is going to save us. And I know a time is coming when this pandemic, when this time that we are going through, we will be back our behind, and we will come back again together and glorify and worship the Lord together, and sing the Lord, where we are, it is you that you have brought us. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord keep on reminding, may we keep ourselves closer to God, especially at a time like this. Because it is only by keeping ourselves closer to Him and calling upon His name, that is why He is going to save us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you because of your word. We want to thank you because you are reminding us that you know us by our names. And you are saying, the Lord, you are there to save us because we belong to you. And because we are your people, Lord, we want to pray tonight, oh dear Jehovah Father, that you may remember us, oh dear Father. May you fight this battle for us. May you remember everything that we are going through, God. There are people who are going through a lot of tough times, oh dear Father. May you remember them. Stretch your hand upon us, oh dear God, and save us, because we are your people. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen and amen. May the Lord bless you and bless you so much. Amen.